You know, in 2005, Aaron Brown was fired from CNN. Not because his ratings were poor, but because he was one of the few journalists alive who actually had enough courage to criticize George Bush at every turn. Brown was replaced with lockstep talking heads who were too lightweight to analyze facts. They were too lightweight to conclude the obvious. News media has become part of, for example, the war propaganda machine. The CNN, we saw the story. CNN was probably the leader in promoting war frenzy rather than carrying on an objective discussion. They didn't ask questions. Instead, they delivered prepackaged, soma-drenched, dullard brain lies on behalf of the Pentagon. John Klein, CNN chief, the genius who fired Aaron Brown for being a real journalist, he then came out and made a proclamation that radio talkers, people who talk politics live on radio every day, no longer would be permitted to appear on CNN because they were too often critical of the status quo. They were too much outside the Washington Beltway, and they fomented too much controversy in criticizing government leadership. The people he was talking about were progressive talk radio people. Instead, CNN built out, they built out a news and news commentary infrastructure that is barely recognizable as either entertainment, news, or news commentary. How's that working for the Nielsen ratings for that wonder kind, John Klein? Well, rigor mortis, it set in almost right after the CNN restructure because Mr. Klein, just so you can understand this, news reporting and news commentary has to be bold. It has to be outside the beltway. It has to talk about things that people want to talk about. You have to actually stand for something. You can't stand in the middle and stand for nothing. There are not enough people to fire around CNN, frankly, to allow it to be looking more like a relevant network again. But that doesn't appear to concern management because advertisers are still willing to pump millions into CNN programming that nobody is watching. Nobody is watching, but advertisers will spend money on programming like that. If you have more than 40 tattoos, no doubt you don't miss Nancy Grace. If you want to simply snooze with a little inconsequential background noise, Wolf Blitzer's Situation Room, well, that's the place to go. But that's the status of a network that was one time relevant. I've had the opportunity to ask many of the most important personalities in mainstream media whether or not they believe news journalism is in trouble. Here's what I found. From Helen Thomas, from Dan Rather, from Phil Donahue, from Bill Moyers, all are in agreement that quality news journalism in mainstream media is either dead or it's dying. It's gasping for a last breath. Helen Thomas, who's worked as a journalist covering 9 U.S. presidents, says that news journalism is no longer capable of protecting democracy. They are no longer the watchdog of democracy. According to Bill Moyers, news journalism, it's been dumbed down to a point where there's no longer an adversarial relationship between government and the press. Instead, the Washington Press Corps today wants to be pals with the parts of government that spin political policy. There's a benefit to being their pal. The result of that relationship is the media pounding the drum, for example, for war where no war was needed. On top of that, they slept through an economic meltdown while government's spin machine drove America towards an economic class divide that has not been seen since 1929, and the damn media didn't even talk about it coming. It's a news media that quit asking tough questions of an administration that trades inside access for childlike obedience. If you're on the inside, you're going to get the story. If you're not, you're not going to get the story. So rather than being journalists, they cave in and they become sock puppets. As we watch the Fourth Estate die, an infotainment creature that has replaced real investigative journalism. I mean, it's flourishing. There is no real investigative journalism. Newsrooms in every part of mainstream media have been underfunded and replaced with talking heads who simply are not bold, not informed, and certainly not entertaining. They're little more than infotainment gibberish, specialist in gibberish, who fill our minds with facts about Kim Kardashian's boyfriends or Octomom's new pornography career. That's what sells. In 1980, 50 separate entities owned the major parts of American media. The media was a marketplace of bold ideas. Liberal, neocon, moderate, all shades in between. Today, only five conglomerates own all of the mainstream media. All parts, books, movies, news, documentaries. Once you understand that, it's not difficult to understand corporate rules of operation, because there's only one rule: always increase profits. Always at the risk of real journalism. In the mainstream media today, both print and electronic real news journalists and bold commentators run the risk of extinction. Gathering real news with higher paid experienced journalists is too expensive. Allowing a news commentator to say what we're all thinking is too damn risky. Don't allow a news commentator to say what's real. Thinkers, dozens of critical thinkers, Ed Morrow, William F. Buckley, those were real journalists. And you know what? They were allowed to say what they were really thinking. They weren't inexpensive infotainment talkers. There's never been a better time for citizens' journalism to flourish today. Today, every outrage, conscientious and motivated American has the capability to create and deliver better journalism on the internet. Just go to places like Talking Points Memo. Go to Crooks and Liars. Go to Raw Story. Go to Brad Blog. Go to all of those sources out there, Salon.com, MoveOn.org. Understand that these products were launched, a lot of them, most of them, in fact. They were launched on a shoestring. Most of them were launched on a shoestring. But they helped change the political narrative almost every day now. Tune into The Ed Show or Tom Hartman or Norman Goldman or Stephanie Miller or Bill Press or Randy Rhodes or The Ring of Fire on radio and understand that in every instance, those products were created with minimal money and a monstrous faith in the idea that the media could be better, an idea that democracy deserves better. Go pick up a half a dozen independent newspapers around your community and recognize that those are the kinds of small newspapers that helped launch independence in America. Again, most of those independents started on a shoestring budget, and almost always they're driven by sheer commitment of people just like you listening to this broadcast. People who understood they could think, they could write, they could analyze, and they could comment on the state of the world affairs at least as well as Wolf Blitzer or Nancy Grace or Pierce Morgan. Citizens journalism is our last best hope. And I doubt there's anyone listening to this broadcast who isn't capable of being a part of it. If you're one of those people who are always saying to yourself, but what can I do? What can I do? Begin here. Be bold. Do something today. Help build a stronger citizens media.